Through the years, our Lasallian family celebrates the life of Lasallian patrons, who are the martyrs and saints who have made great sacrifices to establish the pillars of St. John Baptist de La Salle's vision of providing quality education and to build a society on equity. St. Miguel Pribes Cordero, Group 3's assigned saint, is actually the patron of the College of Liberal Arts and Communications. During the course of his life, he trained himself to become both an accomplished educator and a holy man. This video will make us students further understand how he responded to various issues of his time. Categorized by a timeline of events, we will look into the journey of St. Miguel and see events on where he truly exemplified Lasallian values.
Hi there! Now let's jump into a much more deeper information on St. Miguel Febres Cordero. So he is a saint not because of his precocity or his intellectual ability, but because of the warmth of his prayer life that overflowed in generosity and service to others. He then became part of a religious congregation of men called the Brothers of Christian Schools, commonly known as the La Salle Brothers, dedicated exclusively to education. St. Miguel Febres Cordero, whose full name is Francisco Luis Febres Cordero y Muñoz, quite long, was born into a family that has always been prominent in Ecuadorian politics. He also had this unknown disability of being unable to stand firmly. Moreover, Miguel's family did enroll him in a prestigious diocesan seminary, but knowing Miguel's pursuit to become part of a Lasallian brother, his family strongly opposed as it would exclude him from being part or moving forward to a much more honorable career. On the 24th of March, 1868, he then joined the brothers at the age of 13. He then began teaching at Quito at the age of 15 years old and continued teaching there as a school teacher for the next 32 years.
By the age of 17, St. Miguel wrote his first textbook, and this textbook was even used by the government. During his teaching, many of his students loved him, as he was always looking for ways to innovate on his teaching styles, and by the fact that he was kind to all of his students. Even though it's pretty obvious that he was gifted with great intelligence and wisdom, he was still humble, as he still thought that he wasn't as much as important as he was compared to his other students. He exemplified the values of simplicity, directness, and concern for all of his students. He was also open-minded, as he didn't mind learning from his own students. Because of this, his virtue is docility. Saint Miguel made a formation of the younger brothers and taught in Quito, the capital of Ecuador. This was done because he cared about the young men who joined the order during a rough time in Ecuador, politically speaking. After this, he became an internationally recognized scholar of the Spanish language and known for other academic works.
By the year 1905, he was sent to Europe to translate texts from French to Spanish for use by the order. He worked primarily in Belgium. Despite the signs of his health beginning to decline, he went to a school in Spain where young men were preparing to become Christian brothers. During the Spanish Revolution in 1909, the school came under attack and churches were burned throughout the city. Brother Miguel took the Blessed Sacrament from the chapel and supervised a dramatic evacuation of his young charges to the safety of Barcelona across the bay. Shortly after they were able to return, he contracted pneumonia and he died in February 9, 1910 at Premio de Mor, Spain, where he was buried. His grave was disturbed during the Spanish Civil War and his body found incorrupt. He was then reinterred in Quito, Ecuador, where his tomb has become a pilgrimage site. In addition to being a religious role model, Miguel is considered a national hero in Ecuador for his success in so many worthwhile areas. He was then beatified on October 18, 1977 and canonized on October 21, 1977. We celebrate his liturgical feast on February 9th.
Brother Miguel was basically a man of heroic virtues. Even if he was born into a wealthy family, he made it the priority to serve the people around him as an educator. He was an open-minded teacher who regarded teaching not as a pedestal, which elevates him from the students, but instead as a bridge that connected him and his students together. He was very innovative in formulating ways to keep his students interested in lessons and regarded them just as if they were his friends, but still knew how to humble himself. He did so for his love in enlightening those around him. And despite being challenged by numerous harsh realities, he continued to pursue in his mission to serve the people in his community. Surprisingly, him being disabled did not stop him, but instead the biggest issue he had to deal with was his parents' view of what he should do in his life. Considering that they would allow him to attend prestigious diocesan seminaries but not be a Lasallian brother, we can infer that his parents are more concerned about their social status rather than Miguel. They feel like because they are wealthy and influential, they should be in positions or places that are regarded as socially acceptable for their class, which is why they can tolerate him being in prestigious seminaries and not as a Lasallian brother whose purpose is for the poor and not the rich.
So, to close off this topic, we hope you guys gained an in-depth understanding about St. Miguel Fabres Cordero and the precise events of his life, such as his values and social issues he was facing at the time, that shaped who he was as a Lasallian patron today. Thank you for watching!